Okay, so I've stitched on the heel cap. Two layers of stitching. That's all right. A little wide from each other. Could have been a little closer, but, and you can see this comes out a little bit because I have to wrap around the heel cup right here because it kind of flexes out. I was able to do that with this because the seam comes here, but once you do it with a flat piece, it doesn't want to work around it very well, so it leaves a lot of like extra space. I'm pretty sure I'm doing this right, but I'm actually not 100% sure. I'm a little bit worried that when it comes time to last this, that this is going to be a problem, but we'll find out when we get there. Sorry, my hand's covering the microphone a little bit. I'm holding this. But yeah, so when you fold it, you can see it stretches down flat and it kind of puts some pressure on that. So it should all last out. Because we're gonna dampen the leather and we're gonna stretch it and pull it, and it should work out right. But for now, I'm gonna do another thing where I'm not gonna show you like all my stitching just because it's boring, it's tedious, it's the exact same thing over and over again. And also I just don't wanna talk during the whole thing, I'd rather watch TV. Sorry. But I'm gonna take, so I have this vamp toe cap piece. I have this piece all constructed, the back with the thing around the throat and the heel cap all stitched on. And I'm gonna take this, and you can see that this is gonna line up right here. I'm actually gonna need to find one more piece of something. So, when I cut out the vamp outline, you can see this line, this red line right here, and it's the blue on the other side. Anyway, this line is the lasting allowance that I created, so the actual like tape line was this, and then I added a little bit just so I'd have room for stitching and overlapping and all that stuff. So we can tell where that's supposed to be at, where those tape lines are supposed to be at from the original pattern. We cut these little holes in this, and so just big enough for the tip of the pen to come through. So we're gonna come through and we're gonna mark through those so we know where the original line from the pattern was supposed to be. It'll make a little line across like that, and then we're gonna come and figure out how this connects. So this is gonna be over here, it's gonna overlap. So we're gonna put it just enough so it covers up those line, the marks that we created. And then we're going to clip it down with the gator clips, these things, just clip it in place. And then we're not gonna glue it, especially this time, because I'm gonna do something where I see all those little, the holes that I've made? Oh, my fingernails. I'm gonna go through and poke each one of those for stitching, the same way we did around all this part. I'm gonna use my awl, and I'm gonna poke all the holes, but I'm not gonna stitch it on this side. And then I'm gonna take the whole thing off. I'm gonna repeat the same process for this side, because once you start, if I had stitched this first over here, if I put it all down and I stitch it all at once, then when it comes time to stitch this one, it's gonna be all boot shaped, and I'm gonna have to stitch it three dimensions. But I'm gonna have to awl it three dimensions. It's kind of a pain. So I'm gonna do poke all the holes over here, poke all the holes over here, and then stitch, and then it'll be boot shaped. And then I'm gonna do the same thing for the tongue right here. I'm just gonna fit the tongue in here, and then stitch it. But I'll make another video for that. But for now, the first step is, it doesn't really matter which side because it's symmetrical. We have a symmetrical pattern on this one, so we can just do this. And I'm probably gonna put the camera down when I do this, but I have my little, whoops, my pen where the top just came off instead of the actual cap of the thing. I'm gonna get silver all over my fingers. Okay, got this little cap off. So I'm gonna come, I've overlaid this. I'm gonna put the camera away to actually do this so I can get it perfect, but I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna go in each one of these and make little marks.